to Jazz Night. We're at the middle school at KP, and we're going to open up for you. Our first song is going to be Avenue Swim. Next up is Rock Around the Clock.
Thank you.
Next up is CGM Blues. We're going to have a special guest on this one. Please welcome to the stage David Pope. Oye, ¿cómo va? Thank you. piece is a piece called Second Line, and we're gonna feature pretty much everybody on stage. We're also gonna welcome David Potek to the stage.
Thank you. Thank you. so glad you could join us here tonight. The first three pieces you heard were all by the same composer, Duke Ellington. And his music is really just a gift to humanity. There's just incredible writing for all the instruments. You heard a number of people act as soloists, and Smadi heard the clarinet stylings. On Sugar Hill Penthouse, you heard on baritone saxophone. And Elbow Jangles, we heard from tenor saxophone, we heard from on the trumpet, and we heard from clarinet. We're about some music of Benny Carter. This is Amoroso.
Thank you.
sax, center saxophone, and our percussion section. And guest artist Ryan Lau tonight. We're gonna shift gears a little bit in terms of momentum and style here. Nick is getting paid double tonight for playing trumpet and guitar. We're gonna feature Nick on our next tune. It's a beautiful ballad by guitarist Pat Papini. This is Always and Forever, and it's giving Nick a minute to get set up. Introduce a couple of seniors in the band tonight. Nick is among them. Nick is going off to UMass Dartmouth next year. Hold on, I forgot my sheet. Nick's leaving us next year to go to UMass Dartmouth, where he plans to study accounting and finance with a minor in music. Also, the rhythm section, senior pianist is leaving us to go up to Williams College next year. We just played on Amoroso, our other pianist, is leaving us to go to the University of Massachusetts Amherst, where she plans to major in psychology. Thank you. Giovanni Madrazo on the drum.
Another round of applause for these guys. And let's certainly not forget the middle school kids as well. How about I get the honor of introducing my dear friend Dave Pope. We don't get to see each other as often as we'd like because he's moved down to Virginia and become the saxophone professor at James Madison University. But we've known each other since 1986. My first introduction to David was coming to hear the jazz ensemble on the concert on the Common when I was moving to Rentham. And I saw this kid playing saxophone and go, oh my gosh, what have I gotten myself into? I don't think I can play as well as that. He blew my mind as a 13-year-old, and I thought he was a junior or a senior. So we meet in marching band rehearsal, and I'm like, oh man, I heard you on the concert on the Common, and I'm psyched that I get to be in school with you for a year or two. And he's like, oh man, I'm a freshman with you. So it was very daunting, but it certainly inspired me to practice a little bit. Not as much as I should have, but definitely inspired me to be the best musician I could be. We went off to college together. I was in his wedding. He would have been in mine if my wife and I didn't elope. But I love him like my brother, and I'm so happy that he could be here tonight for you to hear. And it's just an absolute joy to introduce David Pope.
Brought me out to play Solid Old Man.
Truth.
I am in the AARP, so.
Thank you.
We're going to bring up another special senior in the band right now. This is one of the seniors in our trombone section. Matt's leaving us to go off to the Berklee College of Music next year, where he will major in music. Can I get a new sound guy for the next concert? I know, right? Yeah. Hey, anybody out there like a good slow jam?
Always.
Yeah. Doesn't get much better than this one. This is Bob Minster's a long time ago.
such an honor to be here. Boy, let me tell you, I was so looking forward to doing this, and and we were going to do this in 2020. Something happened. I canceled for some reason. I was gutted. So I'm thrilled to be back. It's such an honor. And to Mr. Walloff, the feeling is mutual. This is the community that... This is hard for me. This is the community that built me. I was telling these... and let's give a hand again to these wonderful middle schoolers. Opportunity to work with them yesterday, and I told them I remember distinctly being in the auditorium in band rehearsal. I was in the eighth grade. I've been playing saxophone for maybe 6 months at most. And like a bolt of lightning, it hit me. I want to do this forever. I want to be a professional saxophone player. And I never look back. And the support that I received from my parents, from my family, from my friends, from my friends' parents, from the King Philip Music Association, and thank you to them especially for helping so that I could be here today. It was just an extraordinary experience. This is such a great community. The legacy of teaching that started when Peter Tylston was here, who was just, you know, the most important. It's very important. And I see that this teaching is just going on and on. Mr. Keough is doing amazing work with these kids. Let's give him a round of applause. There's a lot that I want to say, but I'm not going to say it because I go on and on, and I'll start crying again. I'd like to play something for you. Part of my career in saxophone is that I discovered that I didn't have to do exactly what everybody else was doing. In fact, it would be better if I tried to be original and unique. You know, and so when we hear all these great Duke Ellington pieces, Duke Ellington didn't write for a band. He wrote for specific people in the band because they had voices, they had sounds. He knew that the band would sound better if he wrote to their strengths. So I started thinking about what are my strengths? And I loved sound. And I loved all kinds of music, and so I became a very serious classical musician at James Madison University in Virginia, where I've been for 22 years now, which I can't believe. I teach classical saxophone, I teach jazz saxophone, and anything else that you can do with a saxophone I teach. Among my heroes when I was in high school was the pop artist David Bowie. And one of the things that I really enjoy doing is taking a song that I love. You know, we say, oh, a piece, we'll call it a song, you know, songs. And I like to deconstruct it and then try to put it back together again for memory. And when I do that, I always get it a little right and a little wrong, but it's going to be unique. And I like to fold it into the way that I like to play the horn. So I'd like to play for you my sort of deconstruction of David Bowie's Life on Mars. Thank you. This community gave me the gift of choosing a career not based on whether or not I was going to make money or whether or not I would be secure, but on what my dream was. And I found it kind of amusing that over the course of 22 years, the economy has gone up and down and many interesting things have happened, some horrible things have happened. And I've had a wonderfully secure and fantastic career traveling the world and teaching as a saxophonist. So support your kids. Encourage them to follow their dreams. The most horrible thing that happens to me when I'm at work is when someone comes to me and says, oh, I played music a long time ago, but I decided to do something else, and now I really regret it. So the work that you're doing here is amazing, and thank you, Michael, for having me. And bravo to everyone. Thank you.
We've got a few more seniors in the band introduced before we play our last piece. And the trumpet section give a wave, leaving us to go to the University of Rhode Island. Play electrical engineering. Also in the trumpet section, Kurt's leaving us to go to Plymouth State next year, where he'll study electromechanical technology and robotics. And our saxophone section, we've all been four-year members of the band here, too, yeah? Yeah, among others, too, but I have a vivid memory of them being the extension of the saxophone section over here when they were freshmen and playing when we'd let them. So on baritone saxophone. I have decided not to go to college next year, which will major in music performance history with a minor in pre-law, so we'll be pretty busy. Next, Aaron Garrett. The next Aaron tenor saxophone is Garrett is going to the University of Rhode Island, where he will major in music performance. And playing lead alto is Andrew is leaving us next year to go off to American University, where he will study political science. And we have two seniors of the band who were unable to join us tonight, but I did want to announce their names and their contribution because they've been essential in developing this group over the last 4 years. So not able to be here tonight, going off to the University of Massachusetts next year. And thinking about us somewhere in Columbia is players also going off to the University of Massachusetts next year. And before we play our last piece, obviously, thank you, Professor Pope, for taking the time to be here. We appreciate your time, we appreciate your energy, your musicianship, and your teaching. Thank you. To the Kingfield Music Association, who helped us put together this night and fund it, if you'd like to scan the QR code on your program and help us fund future endeavors and future collaborations like this, feel free to do so. To the administration and the school committee here at King Philip, thank you for your support of jazz education. Thank you for your support of jazz education as a curricular part of the students' education. I think you hear that it makes a big difference in their performance tonight. So we got one more Benny Carter tune for you tonight. This one is Movin' Uptown. Yeah, Mr. Wolf. Oh, and also in the saxophone section, saving the best for last. Callan's leaving us next year. Yeah. Counts that off to the University of Massachusetts at Lowell. He'll major in mechanical engineering.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, folks. We got a couple concerts left this year. If you want to come see more groups in this, Saturday, May 21st, we got our Spring Pops concert at the Fieldhouse. 7 p.m. start, doors open at 6. And if you want to see this group again, they're playing this Sunday at the Hat Show on Boston Esplanade. This Sunday at 2:25 p.m. Check it out. See you later, folks. Have a nice day.